Is it getting worse?
I'll just lay down for a little bit. I don't want to miss my appointments. I don't want to throw the schedule off.
Okay.
Deidra Williams was scheduled to begin a first-in-human trial today. Instead, she finds herself entering a potentially deadly sickle cell pain crisis.
We're here at NIH now, waiting for a 12 o'clock dental appointment, but she's having a lot of pain. Thank you. Okay, so Tiffany wants you to go over to the day hospital.
Okay.
Right in there, and your nurse will be here.
Yes, ma'am. It hurts, y'all. It has not stopped hurting. It radiates down my legs.
Deidra's disease causes a malformation in her red blood cells, the very cells that carry oxygen to every organ in her body. In most of us, red blood cells are soft and round, but in patients like Deidra, some are hard and shaped like a sickle.
Instead of being able to squeeze through the circulation like a normal red cell, the sickle cell gets repeatedly hung up in the circulation. And then you just have this logjam of sickled cells in an area that needs oxygen. We hurt so bad because the cells are not getting their oxygen. So the cells are beginning to die. And without restoration of that oxygen, they in fact do die.
Deidra's pain crisis could be a sign of serious organ damage. If it persists, it could disqualify her from the clinical trial.
Hello.
Hey, Dee.
Hello.
Hi.
Hi. How are you now?
I still hurt really bad.
Yeah. We'll give you some more pain medicines so that, you know, you can feel better.
Let me give you a pain medicine.
Sounds good. All right. We'll see you later.
Thank you.
Next week is the planned treatment. We want to keep her as healthy as we can so that we can proceed as planned. Fingers crossed.
Deidra's now 39 years old, so at the point where she's having more frequent pain and more frequent complications for her disease. And, you know, we see patients at around this time of their life dying. We had a patient die the night before he was going to be admitted for his treatment. Patients will die, and you know, part of our job is to manage that, and it's tough.
Got extubated, which means they took the tube out. So I can hardly contain myself to get in there. It's good. It's good news. Good morning. So good to see you like that. So excited.
I'm all off of it.
I'm glad. I'm glad. What a relief. Hey?
Yeah.
Does it feel better? Oh, I love that. I love you.
After 5 days on life support and 9 days since the infusion of genetically modified immune cells, Bo Cooper is finally able to breathe on his own.
Well, last night, and they looked at him, checked him out, and said, like, I don't know, he looks perfectly fine. So I said, well, let's just take the tube out.
Did your throat hurt? Just feels good?
Yeah. It was pretty liberating when he got the mask off. He actually had his arms back like this, like, yeah, that's right. He had that look he hadn't had in a long time. So it's kind of the same posture his hands were in during his pro MMA fight when he come into the ring. We all needed to see something good going Bo's way.
I feel hopeful. I'm very happy to be able to talk again and feel the breathe. It was like a machine that was holding me back. I just couldn't let it hold me back anymore.